Welcome everyone, I'm Marco Zuppone, I'm a Sentinel trainer based in Canberra, UK, and in this video I will talk you about Sentinel LDK Toolbox. Using Envelope is possible to bind an application to a protection key in few clicks, but if you want to create a more complex protection scheme and take advantages of all the security features included in Sentinel LDK, you can use a rich set of APIs as well. Even if you can check programmatically through the APIs if the right protection key is available or not, we always recommend to use Envelope to protect your executable from the compilers, debuggers, and prevent the intellectual property theft. So what is Toolbox then? Toolbox is a tool that helps you to test licensing, admin, and license generation APIs without the real need to write any code and then compile it. You can invoke the API function and get the resulting output without the need to write a compile a program, but simply using the Sentinel Toolbox tool. Toolbox is great for testing because it's able to produce code snippets as well, in many different languages such as C, C Sharp, C++, VB.NET, and Java. And then you can simply copy the snippets produced and paste the code directly in your source code. And now let's see Toolbox in action.
You can launch Toolbox using the Sentinel LDK vendor suite, or you can use the start menu. In this case, let's start it from the Sentinel LDK vendor suite app, and then I click on Toolbox. You can start immediately to play around, but if you like to use the Toolbox not only to test the APIs, but even to get advantage of the code that is produced by Toolbox, then you need to select, before to start, the programming language that you need. So you go to File, Settings, Toolbox, and we select the programming language. I like to use, in this case, C#, and press OK. Now we can start to explore the APIs of Sentinel LDK. They are grouped in three main groups. You can find them here: licensing API, admin API, and license generation API. I'm not going to explain in this video everything about them, how they work, what is their workflow. You can find everything in the documentation, and then stay tuned to our channel because we are going to produce further videos about Toolbox and other topics about Sentinel LDK. In brief, the licensing API is the API that you will use to find out if you have a valid license, so to log in and log out from the license. You can, with this API, encrypt and decrypt data using the software or hardware key of LDK, and you can access the memory, get information about the time, and there are a lot of other APIs call to get some information about all the connected keys, software and hardware to this device, and even there is a call to update the content of the license, so to applying a V2C file, and even to start the commuting process. So let's have a look to the simple one. Let's stay to the basics, and I like to log in to my license. So I click on the login. I select a feature ID. I will select the feature 0. I'm using the demo MA code. If you are using another vendor code, then you need to select to click this button here and select your own vendor code that matches the keys where you want to login. So I will login to the feature 0 in this case, and I press execute. And the resulting status is ASP status OK. So if I want to perform the same operation in C#, I can simply copy this code and paste it in my application. So this is the code that you need to use to do the same thing that we did pressing the button execute main. Let's try to log in to something different. Before to do that, you can note that we logged in, and when you logged in, you created a session. And the session object is here as well. So let's try this time to log out. And I press execute. This is the snippet to log out if you need it. Let's try to log in on a feature that I do not have for sure available. So login feature 9990. And let's press execute. You can notice that you have a different return code. So this tool is really useful to test without the need to use a compiler and program immediately. You can test all the APIs. And another interesting function is the login with scope, where this tool is even more important and useful, because login with scope is a more complex login function that asks, like, one of the parameters is an XML that defines the scope. So the scope can be, for example, only hardware keys, only local keys, only remote keys, or a combination of those factors. So to create this XML, for sure you can refer to the documentation, but this tool helps you a lot because, for example, I want to log in, I want only to log in to hardware keys, and I click here, and this creates for me the XML that, and then creates for me the code as well. So it's really a good help. Create the XML for you. You can reuse it as you like. So if I try to log in to feature 0, hardware key only, and I press execute, let's see what happens. I receive this message because I do not have any physical dongle attached to this lab, and I was before logging in only on the software key. This function is to log out. As I said, I'm not going to explain every single function here. You can refer to the manual for that. The ASP, encrypt and decrypt, you can encrypt and decrypt strings or data using the key. So we can put something here like demonstration to the encrypt. Let's put something there like A, B, C, D, E, F. Or you can even load a file and then save the file if you like for the code that you want to encrypt or decrypt. I need to log in before of all. I need to log in to a key, feature 0, locally this time. So I log in, I go to the encrypt, I have my data there, I execute, and this is what I get. This is the encrypted content. I can try to decrypt it to find out if everything is coherent here. So let's decrypt what I encrypted, and I should get back the function. Okay. What are the other APIs? What is the admin API? The admin API is a set of API that are used to interact with the runtime environment. You can programmatically set some configuration and get the configuration of your ACC, Administration Control Center. So we can try briefly to log in. I execute it, so it's okay. I am able to log in. This set of API does not have yet implemented a code generator. Anyway, so you don't have any particular snippet about that. Let's try to get the configuration of my ACC unfiltered, so I will get everything, and this is what I get. The license generation API is a set of API that you can use to generate your own license. So if you don't want to, let's say, to use EMS, to generate a license, you can use the license generation API and test them through the toolbox. Of course, this API is an API only, so every license that you generate is going for sure to be generated, but nothing will be in the EMS database. So EMS is not going to keep track about what you generate directly using direct calls to the API. Other interesting function you can do with this API is mainly to decode a license and to do other things to the license, so to get info, to decode the current states that could be a C2V file that contains a fingerprint, so you can decode the current status of a license. So that's all about this tool. Stay tuned on our channel. We're going to publish more videos about our technologies. Thank you for your time, and I wish you a very good day. Thank you.